I have been going through some spiritual stuff, and then so that day, I died by mistake because from like over hyperventilating and so forth. So I was over hyperventilating on the floor, and I lost consciousness, and I died by mistake. And so the first thing that I saw was when I woke up, I noticed that the room was different. The room was a different color. It was like green or red, and the energy was different. And then the next thing that I noticed that, you know, like in a casino, the slot machines, they have the cherries and the lines and so forth, that when you hit jackpot, everything lines up in one spot. And so everything had lined up, you know, like at a casino, like you hit jackpot, and it was like cherries. But instead of it saying cherries, it was basically saying, it said, you lose. Or like you lose. So instead of it saying cherries, it said you lose. And it made noise, and I could actually see like casino slot machine. It was nothing that I was just here. I was seeing it. It was before my eyes. Like I could see it. I saw the slot machine, and it stopped on you lose, or game over, or it's over, something like that. And so when that happened, then I noticed I heard some laughing in the background. I heard some laughing in the other rooms, because I was in a living room on the floor, and there was a room right beside me, which was the living room to the left of me, and straight ahead of me was the kitchen. It was the kitchen area, and then through the kitchen was a doorway, and of course to the left of me, the bedroom was a doorway. So, but I heard laughing, and I heard scrambling and rumbling around inside of the room. So I heard all this noise going around in the room, and I was like, what's that? What's that noise? What could that be? And I said, reveal yourself, show yourself. Because I didn't know what it was. I thought maybe it was somebody like robbing you, or robbing an apartment or something like that. I had no idea what it was. So I heard all the rumble, and I said, show yourself, reveal yourself. And so the next thing I know, I saw a demon that came out. I saw a demon come out of nowhere. Demon came out, and it was two demons. It was two demons that was there. One demon, they were, you know, there was some talk between us. I feel that they was trying to get me to come with them, but I was being combative, like I wouldn't go with them so easy. But it wasn't so easy for them, you know, to take you. They couldn't take me for some reason. So they needed to go get some help. So one of the demons told the other demon to go and get somebody bigger that was going to be able to get me to come with them to wherever they wanted me to come with them to. So we were waiting, and they're waiting, and I'm waiting for somebody to come and try to get me to come with them through this tunnel or whatever. But by the time that person could come, or whoever that they went to go get to try to get me to come through the tunnel, was by the time that happened, I had seen like this bright light, this real bright light through the tunnel. So the tunnel was like really, it was like pitch black. There was nothing but darkness within inside of the tunnel. So the only thing I seen was this bright light. And for a split second, I questioned what the light was, but I didn't have time to question it, because my second thought was like, Christ. It was like, Jesus, is that you? And so when I said, Jesus, is that you? Christ, is that you? The light manifested itself from into a being. Into like a foreign being with like who, which had like this supreme, like fathomable light. Lift the phone up. that had like this supreme fathomable light. And so like the light was actually like you could actually like feel the light or touch it because it was fathomable. Like what they say, like fathomable, you could touch it. And but I was embarrassed because I had not believed in Christ. And I thought he was fake. I thought, you know, it was phony. I thought that it was real. Everybody lied. I thought that, you know. But then, so I was really embarrassed and I started crying. And I was embarrassed because he was actually real. And so I was emotional because I didn't believe in him, but he was real. And not only was he real, he had come to, he came to save me from going to hell. So. Demons were still like in the background, but there wasn't saying they were like just talking or anything like that. They were still like lurking in the background. So after like a lot of emotional stuff with me and Christ, a lot of questions, and you know, Christ, he like held me in his arms like a baby, which was I got some like Christ in his eyes. He saw things like inside of me, like he saw stuff inside of me, saw sins inside of me that I had committed, or things that I had did like to other people, or you know, and stuff like that. So he saw the sins, and he didn't say them, but he pointed to me, and he wrote the sins like in gold and light. He wrote the sins in light. I saw them and I just started crying because he showed me all the sins that was inside of my heart. And but he was telling me that he loved me and that he had seen the pain that I've been through and noticed the pain that I have been through. Throughout my life and as a child, throughout my life, and he brought me back to in my childhood, when I was taken advantage of as a child, he brought me back to the situation, and I seen what happened to me, and then Christ, he told me also about. I know I talked in one of my videos about how Christ, how he views us, how he sees us. I just mentioned that. And so, he sees us like when he sees us like as warriors. As like warriors, his warriors, basically. His children, God's children, are like his warriors. So basically Christ wanted me, he wanted to show me hell because I have blasphemed against Christ and I said that he was not real, and he wanted to show me the place where people go when they don't believe in him or when they don't have him or when they don't want him, basically, and decide not to follow Christ. He wanted me to see that place. And so, but, Christ was always going to save me. He was always going to save my soul, my life and my soul. But he wanted to save my soul. He not only wanted to save my life, he wanted to save my soul, from damnation, in the future. So, he showed me hell. We went through the black tunnel. We went through the black tunnel that he came through. Because Christ told me that depending on what, up until a certain point. Okay, so Christ took me through the tunnel that we came out of, that I seen the light, because Christ said that, I'm just gonna stick with me, blasphemy, which is against the commandment of God. I already created my hell portion, and it was waiting for me in hell. So, you die, you're, you know, if you break God's commandments, then your hell is already ready and created for you. And they call it, Jesus called it the portion. It's your portion. So we was on our way to my portion so that we could see my portion. So that I could see my portion. So that I can, you know, not want to come back here. And so we got to the tunnel, we went to the tunnel, and you know, Jesus asked me if there was anything else that I wanted to ask him before I went inside of the tunnel. He wanted to make sure that, you know, all my questions were answered. He told me to ask me to make sure I asked everything right now, because when I left my portion room, I wouldn't be able to ask him anything anymore. I wouldn't be able to ask him questions. So I asked him all the questions I wanted to ask Christ. I know I did videos on that, so you can ultimately go back and look at the videos. The questions that I asked Christ. But yeah, we went inside of my torture room, and it was like the size of a prison cell. Where it was a little, yeah, it was the size of a prison cell. And a screen came down. And I seen a barber, when I looked in the room and I walked into the room, I saw a barber like a chair like you go to a barber shop to sit down in. And so I sat down inside of the chair, and then my arms were strapped down. I can't remember if they was automatically strapped down or if the demons arms strapped them down. So either they automatically strapped down or the demons strapped them down. Because then the demons started coming around to try to like, scare me. He was trying to scare me, and he was trying to get me to blaspheme. To try to get me to blaspheme. So, but the thing about it is, you can't break the God's commandments. So it's about God's commandment. And so the demons will try to get you to blaspheme and stuff like that while you're there, so you can stay longer. Because they knew I was not there forever. I was just there to see my proportion for a little bit. But if I did anything, you know, against God while I was there, I could stay. I could be forced to stay longer. So they would like torture me, try to get me a glass from God. And this big screen came down. This big screen came down. I had all of my sins on it. Because God told me that if I had an accident for forgiveness, He could have like saved me from a lot of the sins that I committed throughout my whole life. But when you go against, if you don't have God, or you know, if you're judged and you don't have God, then you'll get judged for every sin that you ever committed throughout your whole life. Not just, you know, one sin. You'll get judged for everything that you've done in your whole life. Everything. So, because I had blasphemed God, I had to basically, you know, witness all of my sins that I committed. That's what God told me. And so I witnessed all my sins. I remember, like, you know, I don't remember a lot of the torture, but I remember that, like, being cut up, like, demons, because I think, like, there, like when you get cut up and stuff like that, your body will just instantly heal up. It'll get like regenerate. It'll go back to normal. So they'll just like torture you nonstop and stuff like that, but your body will just come back. And so I know I prayed to God and I asked Him when I got back into my body. I prayed to God and I asked Him. Can He take some of the memory away from me? So God took some of the bad memory away from me because I asked Him to. But it was my time to come out of hell. I didn't know how it was my time, but I just knew that it was my time to go back through the door that me and Jesus, my portion room, because I was somewhere else in different rooms. I had to run from cell to cell. Doing something, and I just knew it was my time to come out of hell. So I started running all the way back through the cells, back to my cell that I came through. And so I seen my cell room, and I went through the cell room. I went through the cell room, and I seen, I went through the cell room that me and Christ basically came to. And so I went through the cell, I went through that cell that we came through, and I seen the tunnel, the black tunnel that we came through. So I started running through the black tunnel because I could see at the end of the light, I could see at the end of the tunnel, I could see like I could see the light where I came from. I could see my body laying on the couch. I could see my life. I could see like the physical life. And so I started running towards the light. I ran towards the light, and as I was about to come out of the light, I was about to come out of the tunnel, I heard a deep voice say to me, "Saint John, if you don't abide by my commandment, there won't be any more grace left." And this was the Father. This was God the Father. Because Jesus told me that he's different from the Father. The Father is different. Because when he was in heaven, when he was in the tunnel, Jesus told me that the Father was in heaven. So that would mean Jesus is like silence, and the Father is in heaven. Jesus is like silence. To suffer what Jesus told me about, what they call the death, when you die and then die, and when you die and then, when you die, which means you go to hell, and then you die and then you get tortured inside of the lake of fire. I remember being burned, I got burned on my arm, and the burn was still there when I came back into my body. But what happened was, as I was coming out of my body, and God said those words to me about me abiding by his commandment, or there won't be any more grace left for me. God basically blew my soul back into my body, out of hell. So I felt God gushing wind, and God blew my soul back into my body. You know, like what the Bible says about God, how he blew life into man. He blew my spirit back into my body, and there was a gush of wind that I felt, and I was thrown back, my soul was thrown into my body, and I jolted, my body jolted back, it jolted back because I was in a different position, where my body was, and me and Christ went to the tunnel, my body was on the floor. And then when I got back to my body was on the couch. It was on the couch. So, and so after that, like I said, I prayed to God and asked him to take some of that away from me. I regret that in a way because, you know, I mean, it's a good thing. Yeah, I mean, it's a bad thing because you want to remember some of that stuff. You know, you want to remember that stuff. A lot of this stuff, a lot of that torture, I felt like I was there for a long time. It felt like I was there for a long, long time. It felt I was couldn't breathe. You can't breathe in hell. It was hard to breathe. I felt when I was in my jail cell, the only thing I thought about is I could see when God leaves, when God left, I could see his grace. I could see God leave. I could see his holy light. I could see his glory light. To a different part of the universe, and I always say like hell is like the incinerator or the dumpster of trash where you go or where souls are sent. You know, when you go against God and stuff like that, then that's where souls are sent to, like the incinerator, the pit of hell. You know, it's really, really bad. And like I said, like God, like God, like even here on Earth, we have God around us. And it's peaceful, and it's joyful. Even though people don't know it, or they can't sense it, God is still here because there's joy and peace. But in hell, there's nothing, there's no joy and peace, so there's no happiness. So, like, hell, like, people say hell is on earth, That's a lie. That's a lie. People, that's a true, total lie. Because hell is nothing like that. When you're on earth, there's still peace. We have opportunity because we stand in this God. People, they can take advantage of that. But when you go to hell, they'll realize that it was not to be taken advantage of. Even in, on earth, we have believers in the grace of God because we still feel peace and beauty and light. In hell, there's no light. There's not even a light. So that's not compared to earth. You know what I'm saying? So it's really serious. God, I have forgot about this situation. And it came back to my memory. And it was only through faith, through real faith and love, and forgiveness through Jesus, that I came to believe. And God forgave me for what happened. And the Holy Spirit came into me. And that's how I knew that, you know. And also, God sent me a message through the radio. And He sent the message, a message, a scripture through the prophet John, through the messenger John, that basically says that whosoever believes in Christ, you know, is forgiven. And there's some more of that passage, but Christ sent the message through the radio. I was only forgiven. The Holy Spirit only came to me when I really truly asked God for forgiveness. Asked Christ for forgiveness. Even for what I did in the past, and it's like, God is so good that He kept me alive. He never killed me. All those 3 years, it was like 3 years of unforgiveness, forgetting that whole situation.
Heart to God, you know, really ask for forgiveness, and you'll send that, you'll get that.